Guys, honestly, I'm sorry that this one has taken so long, but this CB kind of crept up on us. On top of that, like me personally, like, I guess like my spirit, my mental has gone really, really casual. I unfortunately also did have to leave my top 10 clan from the last clan battle. And so I'm kind of in like a kind of a limbo, but that's enough of me apologizing and whining. And so with that being said, hi, welcome back to another Princess Connect video. My name is Lace, and today we're going to be talking about Clan Battle 9, a couple of comps. I know it's probably going to be in 2 hours time by the time this video comes out. Unfortunately, this is not a preparation video because CB is right at our doorstep, and this is just the comps. Hopefully you'll be able to make do. And so this month, it's going to be a bit of a process, especially because we can't use the majority of CN guides. However, I'm going to stop harping on, and so let's get right into it. So first off, you guys already recognize this. This is that like really, really famous CN CB sheet. And for you guys who are not familiar with it, essentially like this goes through all of the different months. However, we have started deviating from this sheet. And so I'm just going to give the big, big summary. The video links are over here. We've got the bosses over here as well as the team comps. For this month, it is the 11th month. So 11 UR, which is the month. However, what you are going to see is that most of the comps are going to be filled with the red haired goddess. So B1, B2, actually all the way up until B5. And so the issue with the introduction of Kana, and not only Kana, but Rei as well, is that anytime you see any comps in here that uses Kana or Rei, you disregard them. Kana, the redhead girl, because we can't use her, she is CN exclusive. And Rei is also a no-no because her UE has not been released yet, which is the purpose of herself in that team. However, generally speaking, where you do see Kana, you could replace with a physical DPS. So for example, this could be Akari instead. It could also be another Archer. It could also be a Mitski. It could be anything. But guys, remember, when we go through each of these, the general team comp is going to be the same. We've got defense down, DPS. Defense down, DPS. And so again, all Kana is another DPS. She could be a Tomo, she could be a Kari, she could be a Hiyori. And so that's that. However, for B1 specifically, because B1 Wyvern has appeared in like every single CB, you can go back to an 8th and 9th month over here. And what you can do is that you can scroll up to the very top and use these guys over here as well as these links. It should be virtually identical. It's just that you're going to be stronger and you should be dealing way more damage. So these are just, again, Bilibili links. However, doing this kind of thing, you can only do for boss 1 because boss 2 through to boss 4, even boss 5, like they don't actually appear yet, especially with the introduction of Lai Lai. So if you guys do go back to like my old CB video, the one from last month, CB8, you guys could technically pick up some of the comps for Lai Lai, but like Lai Lai, I think we need to talk a little bit more about him. And so yeah, that's almost everything that I wanted to talk about. So these ones we can use because we do have all of these characters. We can use this one up here. We can use this one over here. If we scroll down a little bit for B4, again, remember this is B4 for the turtle guy. We can also use these guys down here as well and a couple of the other ones. And so lastly, what we do have is B5, which is the Scorpio guy. So we are using the magic comps over here. However, if you guys have watched like a few videos ago, I was like, man, if we're not getting Misato 5, we're freaking screwed. That point still holds true. If you do not have Misato 5, it's going to be really, really hard to run these comps. And so on that note, what I do want to say is that these comps over here, they are valid. And so if you guys do have the prerequisites for this, go have at it, my guys. Click on those links, get those high scores, go get self-critted by Ilya and make me proud. Okay, and so hopefully that is all of the value that we can get out of the spreadsheet. Even in death, the CM bros still help us out. However, that is not the end of it. And so what I've got is this guy over here. Now, this is a big, big chunky boy. Oh man, there's a lot of timelines in here. And so this is a Bilibili playlist. And so as you can imagine, we're going to see a lot of Kanas. We're going to see a lot of UE Rays. However, there are a lot of comps in here that do feature the units that we currently have and don't use, like the Kana and the Rays. And so that's just a quick mention in this one. I think this one looks like it. That looks like a Mitski comp. Let's have a quick look at this. No, we've got a Christina over here. And so again, same. Defense down, DPS. Okay, it's kind of different because Kokoro is kind of like a support, but yeah. So I've just clicked a couple of the lower ones, like the 155 one over here. And so as you can see, we do have all of these characters in the game. And so this kind of logic also persists in this playlist. So you guys are going to scroll down. It's probably going to be one of the lower damage comps. And so my advice to you for these guys is still to start from the top. I know like it's unlikely that we're going to be able to use them, but if you start from the bottom, you might miss something, right? And so I think that summarizes this one pretty well. So this playlist is actually extremely popular. 110,000 views for this one. But yeah, that's this one over here. That's predominantly manual comps. You could auto it if you want, but if you are looking for some auto comps, I do have this playlist over here. And this is essentially kind of like the same thing as the other one. However, it is full auto all the way to B6, which is your enraged boss. And so as you can see on the right-hand side, again, A1 through to A5, which is your lat 1 bosses. And then if we come down here, you're going to see your B1s through to your B6 and your B5. Again, remember enraged boss 5 is technically B6. However, But what I do want to point out is this character over here. Is it up here? No, it's not. Okay, this character over here, can you guys see it? Let me scroll in a little bit. Okay, this, look at that. And so as you can see from the translation, ban means half. And so it's half order. So if you guys do pick one of these comps that have ban order, then just remember that there is a little bit of intervention, a little bit of manual play involved, and don't just let it run auto. Hopefully for you players who don't turn off the auto, this will help you guys out a little bit. I hope that these are the comps that don't feature the Rays and the Karnas and stuff. But otherwise, that's kind of it for this playlist over here. I don't think there's too much left to talk about. However, on the topic of auto, we have this guy over here. And so this bad boy is put together by Mikhail, aka Chaotic Light, #3995. And so big shout outs to Chaotic Light, #3995. Essentially, these are a bunch of team skeletons. However, if you guys have been following me for a long time, these comps, they're all going to be super, super familiar. This is your T2. This is your Jun Saren comp with the Makoto getting juiced up, doing the UBs, getting all those defense downs. And then on top of that, we've got the Summer Cockroach with the Archers comp with this guy over here, as well as some of your other classics like this one over here. So instead of the Eriko, we used to run a Cockroach. Honestly, running a Cockroach instead of the Eriko is still going to work. Wyvern, again, nothing has changed. You guys can run through this and see what you think. However, what I do want to say is that you see this guy up here. These are highlighted yellow as opposed to the other ones, which are highlighted not yellow. And the reason that this is important is because the yellow ones are the ones that hit the hardest. So if we scroll through, this is A2. So I'm just going to head over to B1. And so as you can see, this guy over here. Ah, okay. Okay, okay. The reason why there is no Kokoro on this one, I suspect, is because it's not like pure auto. With the Kokoro comp, you do need to do like the tank swap, which technically is not auto, but maybe that's why. Like, I still would recommend using the normal Kokoro. So there is the S Kokoro over here, like the normal Kokoro on the B1. Anyway, 1.34 mil, 1.22 mil over here. So let's have a look at this guy over here. As for Lilai, I would say that these comps are good. Okay, this is what I wanted to talk about. So in the last CB, let me just make this a little bit bigger so you guys can see. In the last CB, we dumped a lot of our magic comps into Lilai boss 2 because she is apparently weak to magic, right? However, we cannot really do this for this one because like B5 is going to eat a lot of magic comps. The thing about B5, and you'll see in a couple of the other guides, is that B5, the magic comps just do so much freaking damage to them. And so I'll go through this sheet like very, very soon, but like if you come over here, like look at that. Assuming a Misato 5 star, you can get up to 1.7 mil versus this guy over here, 1.26. And because everyone can only run one mage comp, it is in your best interest to actually sync your mage comps into the Scorpio. And so that's my heavy recommendation. Although it says that it does do 1.2 mil to Lilai, I would recommend that if you guys do have some level of coordination in your clans, do sync your magic comps into the B5. But yeah, moving on. Next, we have the Needle Creeper. Oh my god, okay. This guy's giving me nightmares already. Needle Creeper, in my opinion, the best comp that you can use is probably this one, especially if you are autoing. He just does like an insane amount of damage, and you do need that little bit of sustain and defense, especially from the Jun. And on top of that, if we scroll down a little bit, you'll see like it's probably the best comp over here. However, again, remember that these are all auto comps. And so on this one, the Jun comp is also featured, and we can also use the S Kokoro into Archers with the Turtle. But to be honest, this sheet is pretty self-explanatory. Like, it is all auto comps. It is from B1 through to B5. Again, a lot of them are the classics that we do know, and the only like real distinguishing factor is try to sync as many mage teams into B5. If you guys aren't coordinated and you're kind of doing hits whenever, try to at least do your mage teams into B2 then. Because otherwise, mage teams on B1, B3, B4, technically speaking, it's pretty doo-doo. All right, and so with that being said, let me move over to this Reddit post, which is a pretty sick one. And so big shout out to Lone Wizzy for this one. And so what he's done is he's put together this big paint sheet. It's a work of art, let me put it that way. And so guys, essentially he goes through every single one of these bosses and attaches a bunch of different compositions that you can use for them. However, what you are going to quickly realize is that the majority of them are manual. So you see this one manual over here, and then I scroll across over here, manual, manual, manual. And then over to B5, we've got manual and manual. So If these manual comps existed, they're probably going to be in this big playlist somewhere. And so yeah, if you guys do want to use any of these comps, you can probably find it in here. However, let's have a quick run through each of them. So as you can see, so many familiar comps for the Wyvern. I don't even know if I have to say much for this one. There's your classic T1, except without the Suzuna, you've got an Arisa instead. And then you've got these guys down here, Hiyori instead of Arisa, which is probably like the most common replacement. And then Summer Kokoro for Kokoro, which is also an extremely common replacement as well. On the other hand, if you do have Tomo, you could use Tomo instead of Kari. But yeah, generally speaking, you're going to be able to find these comps everywhere. You could probably actually even find it in this spreadsheet somewhere as well. Okay, so moving on to B2 over here. And so again, for Lilai, you are going to see a lot of magic comps over here. If you can help it, try to sync all your magic comps again into B5, but it's okay if you can't. Otherwise, we do have the classic T1 over here, except with a Tomo instead of the S Cockerel. So as you can see, pretty much identical comps with the lifesteal, they're actually able to sustain themselves. But on the other hand, we do have a Jita comp over here. I don't have Jita, I'm not gonna run it. I can't really comment on that one. What I can say is this top one over here and this one over here are pretty reliable, and all the mage teams are definitely reliable. Me personally, I'm pretty sure for CB8, I sunk a mage team into Lilai every chance I got to. All right, moving on, what do we have over here? So now this is interesting because there is no Jun comp over here. And the reason that there is no Jun comp, because Jun comp, typically speaking, is probably like the best auto comp in the game. I don't know how many times I can say that. I'm pretty sure I've said that in like 10 videos now. I've almost made 100 pre-comp videos. But yeah, the Jun comp will definitely work. It 100% works. It's probably going to work on every single boss here. But if you are willing to manual, these comps are the ones that you're gonna be looking at. However, if you do look a little bit closer, you are gonna realize that a lot of them are gonna be double ups. And so what I mean by that is that the majority of them are gonna feature the Mitsuki and the Kokoro, or the Mitsuki and the Summer Kokoro. And the reason I'm pointing this out is because in the prior comps, you're gonna see a lot of that as well. And so realistically speaking, this is where your attack allocations come in, right? So if you use these two over here, you're not gonna be using them over here. You're not gonna be using them over here. You're probably gonna be attacking this boss over here. You can use this comp with Makoto, Hiyori, Tomo, S Kokoro, and Arisa. Instead of Arisa, you could use Suzuna instead. And then for your second team, you could use like one of these, right? And so as you can see, there is only the overlap of like a Makoto in which you're gonna be borrowing anyway. However, on the other hand, the Jun comp, there is a lot of, well, a lot less overlap if you do use this comp. I'm not encouraging you guys to use this or not. Like, if you are going to auto, again, this comp plays itself. But yeah, let's hop back over here. And I think you guys get the point, right? You just need to kind of know if you're going to be using the Mitsuki and the Kokoro in here, you're going to be able to use them over here. And so you're probably going to be using something like this guy over here, that second line or that third line, or the fifth line over here, or the sixth line over here. And again, Arisa for Suzuna. All right, honestly, that was a pretty good look at bosses 1, 2, and 3. So this is the turtle guy. And so turtle guy, we have a couple of interesting comps. A lot of them actually feature Jun because yeah, it gets a little bit hectic over here. But same kind of scenario, right? As you can see, S Kokoro, S Tamaki, you're not using your Mitsuki and you're not using your Kokoro. So theoretically speaking, you could hit with this guy over here on Needle Creeper, the first comp in Needle Creeper, and then you could use any of these comps that don't feature those two units, Mitsuki and Kokoro. And then what about your team three? Then your team three could be the mage comp. You could either sync it into Lilai over here, or if you guys are feeling game enough, or if you do have the 5-star Misato, you could definitely sync it into this boss 5. All right, I think I am starting to lose my voice, but man, we gotta rush it. CB is in like, it's in like freaking 4 hours. But yeah, everything I've said for boss 1, 2, 3, it's very applicable to boss 4 and 5. I'm pretty sure. What the frick? What is this Mimi technology? This is, haven't seen that one before. Let's put it that way. Anyway, for boss 4 and boss 5, they actually do have listed like the numbers, or rather the damage. So this is probably about 1.9 mil damage. And so yeah, that's pretty nice. However, what I do want to point out is this guy over here, or like the skill 1. Skill 1 inflicts physical damage according to the amount of damage received while staying in the shell. And so generally speaking, you're probably not going to be wanting to hit him or using your UBs at that period of time. And so that's a massive reason as to why there are no auto comps for this. UB timing is important because the counter of the instant death class will already fly on the foot. I don't even know what that means. But essentially, you can already see from here, you don't want to hit him when he's reflecting damage to you. Okay, and so moving on to boss 4, Scorpio, aka Risato part. What the frick? Okay, this one's pretty dank. So as you can see over here, this skill 1 does poisons. And so generally speaking, because of the poison, because of the UB, large physical damage to all enemies, all of this actually makes it really tough for your mage team to survive. And so again, I do need to point out these 5-star Misatos. You need 5-star Misatos for these guys to work. Oh, look, Halloween Misaki does exist. I guess my friends were right. But why would you use that like over the top comp over there? I don't know. Maybe she'll come in later. Anyway, that's pretty straightforward. So we've got the pre-enrage at the top, and then we've got the post-enrage down here. Now, what's interesting is you see this comp over here. Oh, whoops, sorry. This comp, this Jun comp, 1.6 mil. It means that you don't have to throw all of your mages in. If there are some people that still have the Jun available, still have the S Tamaki available, they could technically sync this team into the enraged boss. However, every attack that you do sync into this boss, you are technically losing 100k as opposed to using the mage team. And so yeah, what I'm trying to say is that if you can help it, sync your mage teams into B5. I'm pretty sure that's like the 11th time I've said that this video. All right, okay, all right. I think that's it, guys. I think that's it. Last thing, I guess, is for probably you newer players who aren't familiar with this or don't have the stats, don't have the ranks, and don't have the levels to back all this up. My only advice to you is to remember the song. defense, down, defense, down, DPS. Except for you guys, it's gonna be defense, down, DP, and healer. That doesn't really work out, but that kind of makes sense, right? So you do want a healer instead of one of the DPSs. If you manage to live with that healer, as well as the two defense downs and the two DPSs, that's pretty much it, guys. However, if your team is still getting wrecked with a healer, instead of using a healer, just use a tank instead. Miyako, generally speaking, is gonna stand in front of the Kari, and so the Kari will not die. However, you cannot use Nozomi because Nozomi is gonna stand behind Kari, and so Kari is still gonna take that frontal damage. Although Nozomi, technically speaking, does do like an AoE heal and could top up that Kari, but like, I digress. Honestly, I think that's it, guys. Wow, that was a crazy speedrun. Yeah, my voice is so gone. And so guys, let me leave you with a secret message. And that is rushed, because I really rushed through this one. I'm really sorry that this came out so late. For me, the timelines just crept up like crazy and I just did not see this one coming. I'm pretty sure this is, wait, this has been way less than a month. But yeah, unfortunately that is how it is. I hope you guys will forgive me. But as always, if you could drop that secret message rushed down into the comments below, I would really appreciate it because it means you've watched up until the end of the video. And so thank you guys so much. But otherwise, please consider a sub, a follow, a comment. And if you would like to support the channel, there's a membership thing down in the comments or the description below. But as an old wise Rosato part once said, all good things must come to an end. And so thank you guys so much for watching and I'll catch you guys in the next video. Bye-bye.